Can you hear me? Something is different tonight. I can't see what I'm doing wrong, but something's different. Okay, you can hear me. Okay, good. So, wonder why. That's weird. So you guys can hear me speaking right now? Okay, good. Okay. Well, anyway, hey, welcome to the show, everybody. Thanks for joining me. I know you had other places to be, so thanks for hanging out anyway. You can always listen to my show and listen to Granny Tranny at the same time if you want to. I'm fine with that. I'm not going to be offended. Tonight we're going to talk about infidelity and cheating and relationships and sort of the definition of what a relationship is and how it's kind of changing and evolving over time. And then we're going to the second hour play music and just chat and have fun as usual. So feel free to add to the conversation if you like in the chat room, and I will absolutely reply. So, and apparently Lady Slug is out on a rendezvous right now with her trainer. And we're trying to figure out if she's going to ride his disco stick or not. Apparently she wants to, but she's a little hesitant because she thinks he may want more. But anyway, we'll see what happens with that. But I guess just briefly, I'll talk about the whole relationship thing. I was going to say is that, you know, relationships have changed a lot over time. It's like, you know, and people were always monogamous in the beginning of time. Well, no, that's not true. People were not monogamous to begin with. Actually, the guys usually had many wives and it was okay to have more than one partner, or whatever. Through time though, it evolved into having one partner, which I personally feel is the best for me personally. Everybody's different. Some people are fine having more than one partner. Some people need just one, whatever the case may be. I don't judge. I say whatever works for you in your relationship is all, if the two of you agree to it, that's all that really matters. So when you get into a relationship with someone, in my opinion, I think the rules of monogamy or polygamy or whatever the case may be should be outlined from the beginning. you know, you should say, okay, I'm going to actually be monogamous. I'm only going to be with you. We're only going to be with each other. And we're not going to have sex with anyone besides you and each other, period. And so from the beginning, you're clear that this is what our relationship is going to be. It's going to be about, you know, it's going to be about just the two of us and no one else is going to be part of it. And that's great. And that's how I am. And I'm a highly monogamous individual. I am someone who is incredibly, incredibly monogamous. And I do not, hey, Callie, I'm incredibly monogamous. And I actually, have always been that way. I just am sort of born that way. I don't know. Because it's like, you know, and it's not like, you know, some people are monogamous because they are insecure, or some people are monogamous because they actually are sort of, you know, afraid they're going to lose someone or they're jealous or whatever. For me, I'm monogamous because I actually feel, hey, Jess Hart, thanks for joining us tonight. For me, I'm monogamous because I really feel it's the best, form of relationship for me personally. You know, I'm somebody who, I give myself 100% to somebody. And so there's not really much to go around to someone else. And I don't want someone else's attention to be divided. And I've always thought, look, if you're actually going to be in a relationship with me, if you're going to commit to me in a relationship, then you probably should forsake everyone else, because your attention won't be, you can't really, my point is you can't really be present, emotionally present, if you're dating more than one person at a time. People think that they can do that. People feel that, you know, there's a problem in it, whatever, and that's okay. But, you know, for me, I don't think it works personally. So either you're going to be monogamous, or you're going to agree to see other people and still see each other, or not see one another at all. And for, I think that that's the best way, as I said, standing up front, what you want. Now, I have dated more than one person at a time when I was single, but it was never like I was cheating on them. They knew that I was seeing other people. I knew they were seeing other people. We had not made a commitment yet. And so there was no backstabbing or cheating or infidelity or any kind of two-facedness about it. However, if, for example, I got to the point where I knew I wanted to move forward and wanted to just commit, I would say, okay, look, I'm at the point where I want to just be with you. I want to see where this is going to go. And we'll just, you know, I want you to do the same and commit to me. And sometimes they would be willing to do that. They were ready as well. And other times they were not ready to commit to me. And so I would either have to decide if I wanted to continue dating that person and allowing them to see their people until they were ready to come around to me or whatever, or if I wanted to actually, you know, leave them or whatever. So anyway, that's how I am. And I think most people are like me. I think most people are the same way. I think human nature, you know, people will argue with me a lot about this, but I think human nature really is such that people do want to be committed to one person and be monogamous. Most human beings are that way. Most people. Now, there are people who are, you know, as I call them, dogs or assholes or whatever you want to call them, who will be in a relationship with someone knowing full well that they are supposed to be monogamous. You're supposed to be in a monogamous relationship, just the two of you. And yet they still go on dating other people, having sex with other people, and not telling the person. And, you know, I think some people just have literally, I mean, it's been proven actually, that some people have what's called the cheater gene. Some people are just predispositioned not to be monogamous. It's a minority of the human race, it seems, but the majority of people, as I said, are monogamous by nature. But there are a few people, you know, a small segment of the population that actually are predispositioned to being cheaters. And so, you know, I think we all know, and the thing is, you know, if you're like me and you're really highly monogamous and a highly monogamous individual, when you're dating somebody and you meet the bad guy or whatever, you meet a guy that, you know, is not at all going to be monogamous, but he's hot and he's hung and he's sexy and he's exciting and all those things. And you want to just have fun with him or whatever. And then you get to start to develop feelings for him or whatever, right? Well, that's when the problem comes in. If he's been upfront with you from the beginning that he is not interested in a relationship, he's not interested in a commitment of any sort, if he's not interested in monogamy, he's always going to continue to date other people, and you go into it thinking you can change him or thinking that you can, you know, win over his heart because you're such a great person or whatever, you're an idiot. You're a fool. Because I've been there. I did that when I was younger. I was stupid. And, you know, I went through that. I think most people go through that, especially in their 20s or whatever. I did that in my teens, in my early 20s, thinking, you know, dating these guys I was highly attracted to or sexually attracted to, especially, and thinking that I could turn that into something more meaningful, into a real relationship, when in reality, it ended up being that they actually were not changeable. And I always thought it was me. I thought it was my fault. I thought, oh, it's me that's the problem. I'm not good enough. I'm not smart enough. I'm not good looking enough. I'm not whatever enough the case may have been. In reality, it was never me. It's just them. And they told me from the beginning, if that's the case, they told me from the beginning that they weren't interested in anything more. And I still continued to pursue it as if they were. That's my fault. However, there were many, many times, many instances where when I was dating somebody, and I was completely upfront with them, as I always was, that I was looking for a relationship, monogamy, et cetera, looking for a lifelong thing eventually, and not looking for just a one-night stand or just for somebody who just have a fling with, when I was ready to do that. And I would say that to them. They'd say, oh, yeah, me too. I'm looking for the same thing. And then, you know, after a week or two or a few weeks, a month or whatever, depending on how fast it moved, we slept together. And then they would want to sleep together again and again and again and again, because I'm just that good. But they would decide they wanted to sleep together over and over and over. And but they didn't want to commit. And so that would piss me off. Or they would sleep with you once or twice and then they would be done with you because all they wanted to do was get in your pants. Well, that happens too. And, you know, that's what it makes me mad, and I find to be very disrespectful just as a human being to anybody else, because if you actually are, telling somebody up front what you want and they know that, and they tell you that they want the same thing, yet they don't want the same thing and they treat you like crap, then that's their fault, not yours. So if you're up front with somebody, you tell them what you want and they lie to you, I mean, there's not really much you can do about that, right? It is what it is. So, so anyway, I just wanted to talk a little bit about that tonight. And also, you know, just cheating in general and the nature of relationships, you know, as I was talking about monogamous relationships as I, you know, ascribe to myself, some people don't need that. And some people don't want a relationship. Some people just want to have sex or just want to hook up and whatever. And there's nothing wrong with that either. And everybody goes through that phase. I don't care who you are, you have gone through a slutty phase, or you will have gone through one at one point in your life. I mean, unless you're like a nun or a monk or highly religious or something, you're going to go through that kind of phase where you just want to hook up and have sex and just not have any kind of ties or whatever. I went through that whole period too. It was very short for me because I was never really that built that way, but I did go through a period like that, like a year or so in my life when I was very sexual.